Hello, hello, and welcome to the Introverted Manager. Today I would like to show you how to make app-like buttons in Power BI to make your reports more interactive and be able to switch visuals. I will be using standard functionality, which has some annoying limitations, but I will show you workaround. Let's see what we'll be working with and dive right in. Okay, so this is the report that you might be familiar with from previous videos that I did. This is the report where I track my budget burndown. What I wanted to do is to be able to switch between this visual and forecast visual. Give me a second, I will show you. Here we go. We click forecast and we get another visual with forecasted values. Click on burndown and we're returning back to the original visual. And as you can see, we also have button which is active highlighted, which is not standard functionality, but which is possible with some workarounds, which I will show later in this video. I would love to combine those two visuals together in one, but unfortunately, inbuilt forecast functionality in Power BI doesn't allow more than one line in the visual. Therefore, I had to use this approach. Okay. Let's see how to make it. I'll create new page. Let's switch to insert tab. Let's create new shape, which will be background for our two buttons. Let's open format pane and style section. Let's make it white and change border to something more neutral. Something like this. What else can we style here? I think that might work. Let's add a button, the blank one here. Let's change style a bit. Make sure that you have default here. Okay, so let's make it narrower. Let's change the shape. Where is our shape? And let's make it peel as well. Let's add a bit of padding so it looks smaller than the background shape. Okay, 2 pixels on both ends. Okay. And let's make another one. Just copy paste the same button. Okay. And let's adjust background shape. Okay, so now we have two buttons. Let's add text to this one. This will be called burndown. My preference is thin font. And let's add text to the second button as well and call it forecast. And change font again. Now, it doesn't really matter. I will add just random visuals here for the sake of example. But let's add, change it to line chart. Let's add date to x-axis, and let's add baseline burndown. And let's add another one. This one will be, let's add linear regression. Oh well, we don't see much difference, do we? So let's add something else as well. Baseline burndown and running burndown. So at least we clearly see the difference between those two charts. Okay, so now we have those buttons. Let's say this one is active. So let's style it border fill. Let's turn on the fill, and this will be our active button. Again, for the sake of example, I will choose this ugly color, but in your case, spend a bit more time actually styling so it looks good. So this will be our active state. Whenever this left chart is displayed. And this is our neutral state. Just white background. Besides that, for this button, you can add on hover state, let's say a bit darker shade of blue whenever you hover on top. And whenever you press, let's add the darkest shade of blue. Oh, we can see it briefly there. But once you unpress it, color changes back. And for disable it, we will not be using it, so I will skip through it. Okay. Now, what you need to do next is actually open bookmarks and open selection. That will help you later. So your selection pane shows all of the objects in your current report. So if you have a lot of objects, that's what can help you navigate it. For bookmarks, oh, and we already see two bookmarks from my previous report that I showed you here, but we'll make new ones for the sake of showing you the whole process. So bookmarks are our states for the report. You can save different states of the report and switch between them with the buttons. Let's make it happen. Okay, so let's add new bookmark, which we'll call the default, and another bookmark, which we'll call forecast state. And I will rename this one to default state too. Okay. Make sure to click on default state and let's first arrange that one. So let's group our buttons. Call it default state buttons. And sometimes for B, I can be finicky with those groups and glitch a lot. If that happens to you, either just reopen the report or switch between pages back and forth. Okay. And let's copy this group and add another one. Oops. Wrong copy. Okay. Just to be sure, copy, paste, and put it directly on top. Directly on top. So they are perfectly aligned. Okay. Okay. Let's rename this to forecast state buttons. And change the formatting. Okay. Mm-hmm. Or we can just change the positions to save us maybe some time. So let's take the burn down, put it on the right, and change the forecast and put it on the left. But of course, we also need to change the text. So this is the forecast. As you can see, our button is behaving weirdly. Oh, I see. What I'm changing actually is on press behavior. So actually, let's switch back to default and change it. So burn down. Burn down. Okay. Now it's correct everywhere. And this one, let's switch, make sure that we're in default state, and switch, change to forecast. Okay. Damn me. Let's make sure it's correct everywhere. Okay. And let's put it back on top of our other button. Okay, so now we have two buttons with different active states, forecast or burn down. And we have two bookmarks for default state and forecast state. So let's once again make sure that we're in default state bookmark, and let's hide everything that is not supposed to be shown in default state. For example, our linear regression doesn't have to be shown, and our forecast state buttons aren't supposed to be shown either. So this is how, okay, let's put it here. This is our default state, and click on those three little dots on the right from bookmark, and there you can have, and there you can see some parameters, right? In my case, I will unclick data and I will unclick current page because we are not switching pages. That's one. And second, we're not switching filters, drills or sorting. What we're doing is actually playing with displaying different visuals. So that's the only option I'm interested in. And probably good idea, in that case doesn't matter because we have just two visuals here, to limit your effect here as well, either just selected visual or all visuals on the page. Once you have your target state for this bookmark, again, click here and click update. It will memorize current state of the report. So this is our default state. Now let's arrange our forecast state. Let's click on forecast state. Okay. Let's move that report here. That visual, sorry, my bad. Let's hide visuals from default state and unhide forecast state buttons. And once again, I'm removing data and I'm removing current page and clicking update. Once I have forecast state arranged the way I want it to look like, and click update. Okay. I believe we should be done. Let's try it out. Okay, that's switching on bookmarks. If you try to do something with buttons right now, it will not work. We still have two more things to do to make it work. So let's click on, let's switch to default state and go to burn down button for default state. Let's go to visualization pane, and there you should find, action. We need to turn on action and choose bookmark. And in bookmark, let's select our correct state. So actually, whenever we are in default state, our burn down button should be displayed active, but probably shouldn't do anything because we're already there. So I guess we can just disable it. Okay, but our forecast button, our forecast button should switch us to another bookmark. Therefore, turn on action, for type, select bookmark and select our forecast state bookmark. Now let's switch to forecast state to see our other two buttons. Let's select burn down and again, turn on action, select bookmark and select default state. It should switch us into default state. And I believe we're done. Let's try buttons now. Okay, it's switching us into burn down state and forecast button switching us to forecast state. And as you can see, the active state is highlighted on the buttons itself. And let's go back to my previous report. Same content, as you can see. So that's how you can make your reports a bit more interactive and app-like. It's a simple and straightforward technique. I hope you liked it and will be using in your own reports. That's all for today. Subscribe and see you in the next one.